Hi, I'm Girish.
Hi, I'm Sudeep.
And subscribe to Books on Toast, or else you'll get to know all the spoilers before you watch them in the next season.
Or you'll be that guy that mistakes a bottle of phenyl for milk and drink it and die in your own vomit. Thanks.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the GotCast, the podcast with a Game of Thrones twist. Today, we have with us myself, Anuya.
I'm Sharin.
And these two people we found wandering down the street who looked like they had nothing better to do on a Tuesday afternoon than sit here with us and discuss Game of Thrones. Welcome, gentlemen one, gentlemen two.
Thank you.
Who the fuck are you? Introduce yourselves.
After you, sir.
I'm Girish Narayandass.
What do you do?
I write for a living and that's it.
Okay.
Yeah. I am Sudeep. And I have an interesting life, just generally. But as part of Books on Toast and The Hive, so it's fun to always be behind. But
yeah, Sudeep is our silent partner. And now you know why he's silent. Nobody lets him speak. Welcome, guys. As you know, these are our two special guests today. And the reason why we decided to call them for the Game of Thrones episode is because we wanted to call our favorite viewing partners.
Yes.
So lucky.
As you know, Game of Thrones viewing experience is also a very couple viewing experience. And
because of all the sex.
And it has been considered that actually that if couples watch an episode without their significant others, it's akin to cheating in some cultures.
Why don't we take turns all discussing our first Game of Thrones interaction? Like, when did you discover it? How did you discover it? And what was that experience like? Let's start with Sudeep.
So I think just generally binging on YouTube, and I saw this trailer for, HBO had this cool trailer about really big wolves, dragons, or the birth of a dragon, and zombies. Mm. And I'm like, this is some cool stuff.
That's a good trailer.
That's one way to put it.
Yeah, that's a good trailer.
And I think I just then, as per her, cheated for 3 seasons. And then think convinced her that this is just the bomb and this is really cool.
So Sudeep,
we should be watching it.
Yeah, so Sudeep,
she passes out basically. Like, so if you're watching something also like midway through an episode, she'll be like, what the fuck? So
midway through Game of Thrones also?
No, just generally after work.
So Sudeep watches it like really late at night. And it had been 3 years of some viewing things. I don't know what crap he was watching. So I was like, what is this? So he's like, you should watch it.
Also, yeah, sorry. But we had to download. Wait every week to download.
Yeah.
The episode.
This was back in 2011, yeah, na?
So no streaming. Yeah. So yeah, it was a long process. You couldn't binge watch it also. So it was fun, yeah. So that was my first sort of introduction to this magical world without reading any of the books. But then I'm like, arey, ye to kitab hai. Like, wow. It's like very cool. That was after the first episode. After the first episode. And automatically go to Wikipedia and say, what the fuck is this? Oh, this is crazy shit. Like, wow. So that kind of.
Okay, Sharin.
So
he's given away your part of your story, but
yes.
Tell us anyway.
No, so basically, I would like he would come home after like a long night of some comedy show and come and watch this garbage on TV. So there's been a lot of garbage. To put it in context, he watches a lot of garbage. So midway through season 3 is when I thought, okay, maybe I should give this a shot, and that's when I saw, caught up. Then I wanted to read the books. So, and then I read the books. So, yeah, that's essentially what happened. And I think we saw Red Wedding together. That was, I think, our first episode together. And it was quite... Well, you know what happens.
That's
how
romance blooms. You watch the Red Wedding episode.
Yes.
You nudge each other.
Yeah.
If you're unmarried. If you're married also, you nudge each other.
You destroy all thoughts of having children.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because somebody will stab you at any time.
Correct. So that's true.
Which is why, you know, you're not having kids ever.
It's not like a public conversation.
Because you watch the Red Wedding.
Debate on podcast about.
It's too late.
Yeah.
So, what about you guys?
So I was in my first agency working as a copywriter, and so we used to do this thing where we would look at a lot of references when we're looking at ideas, when you're coming up with ideas, right? When you're pitching to clients. And so this was a thing where, you know, someone would call and be like, hey, look at this for reference, you know, look at this for reference. So this was during those days when we were pitching some idea, and I think our creative director, he called us and he's like, have you seen this? And the reference that he wanted to show us was the opening sequence of Game of Thrones, right?
Sure, not ambitious at all.
Yeah, so he was like, he was just, look at this guy, this is like a great opening sequence. And that's the first time I remember standing in his cabin and we were watching that, and that music was playing and we saw the whole opening sequence and I was like, oh, this is great.
Hmm.
But he didn't speak anything of the show. Like, he was just going on and on about how the good the opening sequence was. And so, and because we were also in the middle of pitching an idea, so that wasn't the thing about like how good, great the show was.
Mm.
But that was the first time I was introduced to the show, but then I forgot about it.
Huh.
And then later, my roommate brought it up and he was like, hey, people are talking about the show, you want to watch it? And then he started, I'm like, yeah, ye to us din dekha tha opening sequence, the reference ke liye, that we couldn't pull off.
SIJ, we will do a budget.
And then we got hooked onto it after the first episode.
It's also one of the few opening sequences like I will watch every time.
Yeah.
And I feel there's just something hidden in every frame.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I remember you telling me this. Huh.
Yeah.
And they change it according to which cities you're going to be in the episode.
What the season is going to be about.
Yeah.
Those
so
are great Easter egg like things.
You know the
find.
Things are happening in Dragonstone if there's Dragonstone in the opening sequence.
Correct.
Yeah.
So for me, I was sick one day and someone gave me the whole season and I spent the whole day watching it. I binged it before binging was a thing. Yeah, because someone had kindly downloaded the whole season and I felt sick and they were like, yeah, this will make you feel better. And it did.
It did.
It was better than anything else.
Yeah.
Any medicine.
Yeah.
Fuck medicine. Just give me more Game of Thrones.
Huh.
So I watched it in a day. All 10 episodes in one day. I didn't do anything. I didn't eat, sleep. Whatever. Just 10 hours. Let's get a little bit deeper into the story.
Yeah.
So who are your favorite characters? Rather, if you could bring back one dead character, who would it be?
Oh, Oberyn Martell.
Really?
Yeah. I feel like he was a... Especially also in the books, he's a very well-written character, very well-rounded. There's a whole backstory to him and the Vipers and the Sand Snakes and everything. And none of that really makes it to the show, I guess, because people knew getting in that he's going to be like... anyway, so but because of that, like I think if we were to bring him back, there would be a really rich sort of, and also it's the only free nation, right, in the Westeros Empire.
Mm.
Where is he from?
Dawn.
Thanks.
It's okay. So everybody here has forgotten us a lot of what they watched. So
yeah.
There's
going to
be
blame people.
Wild errors in this, and
yeah.
That's okay. We are all human beings and we all have lives and jobs.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
It's fine.
Yeah. He seems
and
like a really nice.
Of characters. Just,
also
it's okay to admit, it's a lot to remember. It's fine.
It's true.
Yeah, exactly. So I feel like he would really add to the cinematic quality of the show if he were like at least like introduced a season before, and then you could like, you know, in the next season, it's fine.
I think I would bring back Ned Stark.
For sure.
And the only reason, I think I didn't feel bad for any of the other deaths. I think that was fine. They died at school. It was entertaining. I just want him to come back because somewhere, I think that was the first shocker in Game of Thrones when he died.
Yeah.
Right.
So that hit the most.
Correct.
After that, you started getting used to shit, right, of people dying.
Mm-hmm.
And also, I just want him to come back and be like, yeah, mere bacche itna achha kar rahe. Like, I just want him to come back and
be
like,
to have pride. He'll be like, Arya is a serial killer.
But wo achha kar rahe.
And Sansa is a rape victim and Jon is a zombie.
But she's
and
gotten rid of a lot
Bran
of
is
bad
a,
people.
Bran is some sort of psycho.
See a tree.
Yeah,
not,
Raven. Like, dissociative personality disorder.
See, I think Ned would look at it differently.
Because
he
his
would...
head is off his shoulder, that's why. He'd look at it differently.
Yeah. So I think he'll just come back and just see his kids, like, be on top of things, I think.
But, like,
right?
If he would not to die, they would not be like this.
Yeah. No, come
yeah,
back now.
I mean, that's like the time travel thing, right? If you go back and kill your grandfather, then can you still be born?
Dude,
like, wo to nahi hai, correct hai. But I think you're getting bring back, right?
Yeah.
So if I were to bring him back now, so he died, his kids became cool and they got on top of things. And then he comes back and then he's just like, dekho mere bacche. I just want him to have that moment, that's it.
Recon engineer banega. Who would I bring? Oh shit. I made the questions. I didn't think of the answers.
Lollies.
Yeah, I would bring Roz the prostitute. thought she was
Oh, yeah.
She was a nice person. She didn't deserve to die the death that she died.
Yeah. Oh, as opposed to everybody else.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm not that
fucking dumb. I'm sorry.
Not Ned Stark. Red Wedding was.
I mean, they were also
so
two writers for my liking, to be honest.
I mean, they didn't deserve to die like that. But like now, if you bring back Robb Stark, so the other person I would say is Catelyn Stark. I feel like she should come back.
Interestingly, in the books.
Yeah, we'll get to that.
Yeah.
But she could have come back. But I think Ross, the prostitute, who's not in the books, by the way.
Yeah, she's not in the books.
Didn't deserve to die at Joffrey's hands. Mm. So maybe you could bring Joffrey back. Lots of people. Loras, Margaery. It's like there is a website called deathtimeline.com, which has every single death in every single episode plotted as per timeline.
Yeah,
people have nothing to do.
People with time,
what?
A lot of free time. A lot of free time.
Yeah, they have nothing to do but this.
I think for me, it's the direwolves, man. Between each of them, I think from whatever I've read in each of the stories, like they have a lot of, they have a deep connection with each of their owners.
Yeah.
And
they weren't really used.
Yeah, they weren't really used because like the history of the wolves is that they're huge beasts, and I don't think I saw much of it other than like in fleeting moments. As much as they've focused on the dragons, they should have also had like a dragon versus direwolf.
Ooh.
Face off, which is anyway not size proportional, but like,
yeah,
they could have used direwolves more. I felt like what he rightly said also, that first scene where Ned Stark is beheaded and Sansa's like fully in shock, and then like everyone around him is pleading to Joffrey, and then when they kill him, and like, oh shit, this kind of story like should have started from now, like, he and then it was just after that, you get sensitized to everything, so you can't say like Robb Stark, his wife, everyone is just,
I think that was like a big point where the makers or the author, they were just like, "Dekho, ye hone wala hai, ye show hai.
Yeah,
you're gonna care for people and they're gonna die." This
Correct.
Is that was the first point with Ned Stark that happened,
That's
right?
True. I agree.
So yeah, and also by the way, Arya, I think she's like the Dexter of this universe.
Yeah,
she's a serial killer who kills.
Righteous serial killer.
Yeah, so I think they've all become really
she has
badass.
A code. Yeah.
They've all become really badass in their own right.
From that perspective, not that anybody would wish any more characters die, but if there was one character that you guys felt you could spare from the Game of Thrones universe, which one would it be?
All the 2-3 people that are left.
Who would you kill? Kill off, right?
Like,
Podrick Payne.
The Iron Islands guy.
Euron Greyjoy,
that new...
That fucker is very
annoying. He's a new, what do you call, Ramsay.
They keep bringing...
The new Ramsay,
villains. He's a very bad Ramsay.
Yeah, stand-in. One stand-in asshole has to be there. There's a spot in Game of Thrones where there is an asshole spot. They're like, ye marega, main naya asshole leke aayega. That people keep wishing for ki aap marega, aap marega, aap marega. You just wait for that.
It's a waste of a space.
Because otherwise you'll start looking at how screwed up the characters are. The supposedly good guys.
That's true, actually,
all the energies towards that one villain.
You need the complete black for you to see the grey and the white.
Otherwise, hello, Cersei.
Is she complete black? I don't know.
She
even now
destroyed
she is.
Destroyed a sept full of
now she is.
People.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Without like any remorse.
Yeah.
I think there's a large group of people that like root for her. Like, you know, I think
that's,
you know that the
work
of
she. A very powerful
she.
Woman.
Yeah.
Like, as in like, from a woman, female character point of view also. Like, you hate her, but at the same time, you'll be like, oh shit, she can't top this. And then she tops it with something else.
Something else, that's true.
But also, I think it's easy to empathize with her. Because you understand her motivations. You understand why she is the way she is. I mean, and she is evil, no doubt about it. We're not saying she's a good person at all. But like, you understand why she's become like that. Like that walk of shame. I mean, in the show, it is something. But in the books, like, you really, at some level, I was really like getting into, oh my God, what is happening to her is wrong. No matter how much you feel like what is happening to her is right.
That's a good point.
That's like, that really, like, that's what George R. R. Martin did really well. He built these characters with so many flaws that you understand deeply what the psychology was becoming, and that's just intense, man.
Yeah,
Euron Greyjoy, I think we all can agree. Do you?
Yeah, let's kill him. Let's kill that asshole.
Yeah.
How do you think? What is the point of Jorah moment also? He's just Channa mere aga rahe har. Why is he there? Like, nobody knows. Why is Gilly there?
Yeah, he's just.
Oh my God, I will help you. Exposition. Cool. That's Gilly's character.
Jora moment has just been saying, he's just been saying palat for the last 7 seasons. Aur wo nahi palat rahe.
Aur usko grayscale hoke cure hoke wapas bhi aaya fir bhi dinner is still not getting
him back. Abhi bhi nahi palat rahe.
Actually sleeping with Jon Snow, they have as much chemistry as those dead people.
That those scenes really irritated me in season 7, man. Those jabardasti ke scenes when they're in Westeros and they're trying to have a conversation. I'm like,
kiske beech?
Between Jon and Daenerys to build that kind of chemistry, right? For that last scene.
Yeah.
They are just like jabardasti ka having these philosophical conversations. Oh, like, mera dragon dekh. Aray, mera ye Westeros. Tu mera Winterfell dekhegi.
Yeah.
Like, ye kyun chal raha hai? Ye kyun?
All right. Let's talk about our issues with season 7 of Game of Thrones. Because I felt like that was their weakest season. And yet their most highly anticipated one.
Yeah, all the storylines were coming to a head. And I think a lot of the predictable shit was going down. Because you would imagine everybody's story arcs colliding.
We all loved Game of Thrones because of how unpredictable it was. And then in season 7, it got predictable.
So what were your issues? Like what... Tell one by one.
What do you
hate? I don't have so many issues. Yeah. I don't know why people have issues with something
else. I was like...
So good, it's entertaining. I feel, you can be unpredictable, but I think for the sake of being unpredictable, then it doesn't work. I think they have to now start wrapping up things.
Right.
I think the only problem I would say I had was more than the unpredictability or predictability of it, I think it was rushed. I think like it needed seven season needed 2 seasons. Like it was, there was just like, aray, 6 season humne itna still rakha camera, abhi fatafat khatam karo.
Just
wrap it up. So now I think all the ends that they have to tie up, all the arcs that they have to close, all the resolutions, rushed now. But
I just really had a problem with the Gendry running to, like, things became, everybody, Jaime Lannister was kept, fell into the water, almost died, survived, saved by Bronn. Gendry ran back to Daenerys just in time. Matlab wo itna lamba wall hai. People go there and they can't see in front of them.
Timeline.
And Gendry, and she came from Dragonstone.
I forgot about that.
Within to save them.
Distance became a big point of conversation.
Yeah.
But guys, she flew. It takes 3 days to reach Chandigarh, but I can fly in 2 hours.
Yeah.
Like,
she must have used her miles.
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah.
Dragon miles.
But didn't you think it also built up like 2 really strong female opponents? Like, so it culminated in both of them like showing like, so Cersei kills everyone in the temple and she destroys everyone with her dragon. So I would agree with Giri saying that I didn't feel like it was a disappointing episode because I got to see a lot of dragons.
And like, I was happy. I was waiting.
A lot of CGI and a lot of fights and it was just really cool.
Apart from the crazy one-liners, I mean, then the second thing is dragons. I mean, by now we all know that that's a plot amazing, a world bahut rich, hai, characters amazing, you pata hai. So now you're like 7th season, you're just like, just bring on the one-liners and the dragons. Like, then you're just like, cool, man. Yeah.
And Tyrion for me is also like my favorite, one of my favorite characters. So he's developed like really nicely in this episode where he's standing on his own. Like he's finally got control. I mean, and respect, I think, from Daenerys. So it shows quite nicely in this one.
One arc that was highly criticized in this season that I would like all of you like to comment on, which is the whole, what's his face? Littlefinger and Sansa and Arya. That whole plot. Right, which was running, that ended with that
reveal.
The reveal.
Yeah.
The twist. Correct. The twist hearing. The twist hearing. Yeah. So, what are your thoughts? Like, you think it was rightfully criticized?
I think it was really rushed. I think it was super rushed.
I feel like they had nothing to do Sansa and Arya that season. So they pit them against each other.
Like they were suddenly back in Winterfell and doing like some Saas Bahu weird shit. Like, and I'm like, why are you doing this to me, man? You have survived like really gruesome rapes. You have traveled like this distance. You have fucking killed Ramsay Bolton.
Yeah.
And then now you're sitting here and like fighting with Arya, who's like this like next great serial killer.
That's interesting. So would you say it was hard for you to buy that they would fall in a trap like this after having seen so much having defeated...
I will not put it past them because eventually they're still like Stark kids, right? And Stark kids are very righteous.
Like, think about it. Even Jon Snow is a bit thick skull.
But Arya has always been about family, man. Like, she's always gone looking for family. So, even when she meets Sansa, I didn't feel that there was any
need.
Also, like, loss of love, so to speak. Like, and but it was just that, like, she's become the biggest person in the household now.
Right.
Like, she's become this ninja assassin. Like,
no, because one of the criticisms that I saw of that whole plot was that, like, most people saw it coming.
Right.
Which is what the whole thing was, that hey, we can't buy this. Like you said, no, she defeated an entire army. Arya has become like a this killer, this assassin and all. Like, can they really fall for this when someone's trying to pit them against each other?
Yeah, considering specifically also at the time that she was an assassin, the way she plotted and killed and stuff like that.
Yeah.
How would you like then, you know, I mean, that's
but Arya and Sansa were hated each other at the beginning of this show.
So the makers of the show were just counting on that.
Yeah.
You would
but
consider
people didn't
that
remember
and buy
that,
this plot.
I think. I think that recall memory was not.
They had nothing in common. Arya always wanted to be a boy and Sansa always wanted to be a lady and a queen. And so they always were at loggerheads.
Sisters, no?
As
so
sisters.
The
yeah, but
the
in
day.
The end they are stuck. No? The pack survives and all.
But if you had probably drawn out the scenes, like you guys rightly said, was that if you had created more believable conflict, if there were decisions based on what he was telling each of them that they went ahead and executed, and then that caused each of them some sort of irreparable harm, then you would believe it.
Then it would believe it, yeah.
This
true.
Is
sure, it
yeah.
is anything.
Writers ka budget CGI mein chala gaya.
That's true. And you know the reason why you don't see that many direwolves, Sudeep, is also CGI budgets.
Yeah, they want
to
see dragons.
Afford, they can either afford a dragon or a direwolf.
There was that one scene with Nymeria and her pack, no?
Yeah, they did it.
Yeah.
Nymeria came back. Also very satisfying.
So in the books, no, Nymeria is raising her own army.
Yeah.
Oh.
So she's preparing for a revolution and she's gone back into the deep forest and like really like getting in touch with the entire pack. So they, if you're not a reader,
like
that will
stalk.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like
no,
humans.
No, no. Like
No.
Not that. No,
she's not planning a revolution. She used revolution. That's why it's got confusing.
No, but like
she has a pack.
Getting them together.
But that happens in this season. But one scene.
It's lost, I think, on the viewer who's possibly not aware of the mythology and the history and not read it.
I think everyone needs to read the whole, I mean, to get the
series. Have you guys read the books?
Started a little bit.
I haven't.
No,
I haven't.
Yeah.
We are still marrying them. Look at us, such benevolent souls.
Married.
Married. Staying with and marrying. Why is nobody giving me an award? Huh? So you haven't read the books. Why haven't you read the books? Didn't you feel enough peer pressure from us?
Why didn't you read the book?
I think just time, I guess, for me. But I get a lot of my information about it on some backstory that someone's already done a summary for. So I feel I've gotten summary plot points on everything that's not in the movie. So hence, but yeah, I would love to get to the books sometimes.
Yeah, I think for me also, I think just time. I'm not very good at managing my time. So I think that. And also I feel, I mean, also I feel mostly like if it's a good show, sign language yahan par aa jayega. Subtitling. I mean, if it's a good show and as a writer, if I'm like, I also watch it from that perspective. Like if I'm trying to get, if I get to see all those characters being nicely fleshed out and written and, and it's a nicely written plot, then I'm like, okay, it's the same. I'll read the books just to enter that debate of books versus the show. So
no, that's not true.
I mean, I'm sure there's something more I'll get from the books. I'm sure.
It's also, but the thing is, the books, no, the storyline in the books, I mean, though largely it's the same, but a lot of character arcs and plots are different. For instance, one thing that has kind of bothered me, though, I mean, in the larger picture, it doesn't really matter. So, Catelyn Stark was brought back from the dead by the Lord of the Light. And even though, like her neck was cut off.
Mm. Basically, Beric Dondarrion is dead. And his life has passed into Catelyn's body.
So, she is Lady Stoneheart now. But she's now stone cold and she feels nothing.
She
and
just kills people.
She kills people. So,
like
she's
the Dark
just
Phoenix
like a,
from X-Men.
Yeah.
I'm just... Yeah,
and she sounds like Darth Vader.
So I was excited about.
Cut. I'm not joking.
Yeah, she has this really like raspy view.
To my
I am your mother.
It's like Lupita Nyong'o.
No, but at least then the book answers the question that all the viewers had. Ki ye baaki logon ke saath kyun nahi kar rahe ho? Jo Jon Snow ke saath kiya. Baaki logon ke saath bhi karo, jo important hai.
Excited to see ended at Jon Snow's death.
Yeah, at this point.
Uske aage gaya
hi nahi. Uske baad likha hi nahi hai. But also I was excited to see how they would bring her alive on screen because she's such a visually like like especially when she's brought back from the dead, she's described so visually
right.
in the books that you feel really curious about what her role would be.
Yeah.
But but having said that, if she were alive, a lot of other characters that are alive would be dead. So
yeah.
it's kind of like weird.
Doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. So guys, what do you think will happen in season 8? Like,
oh,
what,
I have many theories.
Yeah.
I'm very excited about this because I've been like thinking about this for 2 years. So, so number one, Samuel Tali will definitely survive because somebody has to write the story, right? Because he's being training to be a grandmaster and he can like write and blah, blah, blah. So that's definitely true. Gilly, I don't know what will happen to her anyway. But my favorite theory is that Daenerys and Jon will definitely make more love, maybe, and have a baby. And in the Game of Thrones history, right, if you go back, most dragons are born and their mothers die. So I really feel that Daenerys will die she will die during childbirth, and that Jon Snow, who is now Aegon Targaryen, as we know, another Aegon, will be the next king. Then suddenly there'll be a jump cut to 20 years later where both of them are dying. Both of them are flying dragons. So that's how I feel like the series will end.
How cute.
Thank you guys.
Wow. How cute your dragon part 4.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
By Pixar.
That'll be the crossover, yes.
The crossover.
So I feel Cersei and the Mountain will have like a really brutally horrible death to die in some very exciting way. So, and also I'd just be, I think, more keen on a fight scene where the Mountain removes his helmet and you
and
see
you
his
see.
Full face.
I don't want to see.
So between the Hound and the Mountain.
That, I think I want the Hound to live because he's been always a great character. Like he's a survivor, he's helped and also he's backstabbed at the same time. But I agree with her, like I feel that she's going to die for sure.
Daenerys.
And Jon Snow is going to be victorious and Cersei's going to die. A horrible death.
I feel that the White Walkers will win.
I forgot to leave.
Yeah.
Sorry, fool.
All men must die.
Like they will all. Yeah, because all men must die.
Die,
and these everybody will become a
White Walker.
Yeah, I think eventually everyone will become White Walkers. And Tyrion will become Night's King. But I think to give us hope, they'll also show the Children of the Forest being reborn.
Bran
will survive. I feel like the only one who will survive is Bran.
Taking from yours, everybody will die. And the Night King is going to sit on the throne. And throne se do haath aayega aisa, which will kill the Night King.
Kaun se kiske haath hai?
Throne ka do haath aayega. Iron Throne के दो हाथ निकलेंगे, that will kill the Night King.
How is Iron Throne के हाथ निकल रहे हैं?
That is the fan theory.
There is a fan theory.
It's
ये उसकी पता नहीं क्या हो गया ये.
वो रात देखिए
ना. The Iron Throne will come alive.
I'm gonna throw some popular fan theories at you guys.
Okay.
And you tell me what you think.
Okay.
If they're true or not.
Okay.
So one of the theories is, and I find this the most probable and most intriguing, is Tyrion conspiring with Cersei to throw Daenerys under the bus. No, I know it sounds wrong here, but in the last season, he has a conversation with Daenerys about who will take over. See now.
Succession planning.
Varys has always been behind the kingdom. Right? He's been trying to plan things for the kingdom and never for one family or the other family. Tyrion has always been Varys' favorite. The one that Varys was sort of raising in his own image is what I feel like.
So
Varys was Tyrion's father figure.
Like best friend. Father.
Yeah,
bestie,
right? Yeah. Tyrion is now thinking about the kingdom and who will take over after Daenerys, because she's not thinking about the line of succession at all. And if she marries Jon Snow and they become king and queen, then there will be no kids. So then once again, chaos and war. Cersei is pregnant.
Oh yeah, we forgot about that.
And the last scene where they talk, we don't really see how that conversation ends. He just says, you're pregnant, yay! And also because the Lannisters are a family and he's done nothing to keep the family together. And he says that also in the end, that I killed out. If it weren't for me, you would have had a mother, father. And he's responsible for the deaths of Tommen and Marcella, according to Cersei. So I feel like this will be his act of penitence.
But he might kill Cersei and raise the kid.
But he hates Cersei.
Yeah, that's I would believe that.
He might kill Cersei and raise the kid, saying,
"Maybe."
Uske haath se.
I will now make the next Lannister better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he won't succeed. unless Cersei is on the Iron Throne and winning, that kid won't succeed. She has to win.
Who is waiting for Ice Dragon? Not Ice Dragon. Sure. Ice Dragon
Ice
versus
Dragon.
Fire Dragon.
Fire Dragon. Fire Dragon. Oh, yeah. Who is waiting for that?
Yeah,
that's
that is like just waiting for that.
I think that's the face off that everyone is going to focus on.
I think more than it's Mountain versus the
Hound.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ektaraf.
Yes.
Or Ice Dragon versus Fire Dragon.
Correct.
Ektaraf. It's just these two big battles. Everybody's waiting for that.
Yes, I agree.
So another popular fan theory is that Samwell Tarly is Aegon Targaryen, the one whose head was smashed by the Mountain. So he is Ilya Martell and Rhaegar Targaryen's son.
So he's also
who was
a
taken
Targaryen.
Away by Varys. Yeah. So the theory is that he was given to Randall Tarly because he was...
As a ward.
Yeah, he was...
Who's Randall Tarly?
Randall Tarly's
papa.
Samwell Tarly's father.
Oh, fuck.
He throws him out of the house. And
can't remember all this. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
That's why I should read the books. Then you remember all this.
Then,
if
that
is what you choose to do with
which
your life.
Which is why Randall Tarly is so mean to Sam.
Yeah.
Because he's not his son.
He's not his son. And also because then there is also Tyrion Lannister is Mad King Aerys' son. And he's the third head of the dragon.
Guys, so then do you think the Night King is also Targaryen technically because he's now flying the dragon?
Possible.
Because I mean...
What are the other fan theories? Like?
The one popular theory that I have a major issue with is that Bran is the Night King.
But it's like...
That is kind of like just...
It's the same structure, like the face structure, everything is the same. Like they show it in...
But then maybe
Bran
can be the Night King. He's precipitating everything.
He's traveling through realities. Like, so he's possibly facing a future self, like in some other...
Oh, I have one theory. One proper theory. I have this theory that... I have the theory that Bran... will end up controlling one of the dragons since he's a warg.
Ah. Oh, so he would warg with the dragon.
He would warg with one of the dragons.
It would really help
that
if he walks
so
with
cool.
the ice dragon. Oh, so he walks with the ice dragon, where comes the Night King?
Possible.
Yeah.
Because now he's walked too far.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just missed that. Yeah, but sure. Yeah.
He's also, there is a theory that he is Bran the Builder who built the wall.
That I
Bran
believe.
Bran the Builder.
Yeah,
karke dikhayenge.
Can't, you can't not say.
Bahut sare theories hai. Guys,
yeah,
but very...
Bran walking would be, with a dragon
be
would
cool.
be very
yeah.
cool.
Fuck,
yeah.
that'll be like an
very
interesting
cool.
In the books, John is also a warg. By the way.
Yeah.
He and
John
Ghost can,
walk
oh.
with each other.
Walk
oh.
with each other, yeah. They walk well together. They are... Yeah.
Just take a walk in the park.
Yeah,
like
in the snow.
Back
it's a long walk
yeah.
home.
It's a long walk.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
beyond the wall.
They walk in each other's shoes.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Walk will they do each other without each other?
I thought it was over.
Who let the
was
walk out?
Oh, wow.
When they have sex, it'll probably be woggy style.
Woggy style. One gonna top each other and it just what?
Yeah, but in walking style only one of them can
top
the other.
Oh, I walked into that one.
You walked into that one. Welcome to the party.
Is there any like death that really underwhelmed you? That you thought that would should go all big and then it really underwhelmed you? Like,
oh yes. Who's that? This guy in the forest?
I will help you.
Yeah. The guy who's killed in the forest.
In the forest, somebody's dead.
Arre, by that lady warrior. No. By
Brienne.
That,
Brienne.
By killed by Brienne.
Katniss Everdeen.
Nahi re. That king who's...
King?
Stannis Baratheon.
Stannis Baratheon.
Oh, yeah.
I feel Ramsay Bolton ka jo death tha wasn't as brutal as he deserved.
Kya
dude, like, no, but being eaten by dogs is like something
that's
you can
brutal.
Hear.
His
own
house.
It's not so brutal.
My
his
God.
Own house.
That doesn't scare you?
But who no, man. Like, look
his
how much he tortured
people. But those hounds were his instruments of torture. He loved those hounds. The only thing, I mean, not really, but like they were his ex, like that's what he did.
So I feel like it was too short-lived. I feel like the way he had meticulously tortured Theon, Greyjoy, and I mean, they spent episodes. Isme to ye war hua. Kutto ko
okay, so I feel like
which the in the books, right, the way they reveal that Reek is Theon Greyjoy
was
amazing.
I agree.
Why,
that was amazing because you can't see who's playing Reek. So Reek was
it's a reveal in the book.
Yeah.
You don't know Reek is Theon.
You have a Reek chapter and then Reek does Reek things.
Oh, there is no that scene where you say you're Reek now, you're not Theon.
No, there's just a Reek chapter and you think it's just Reek, and then you find out that Theon has been reduced to this. That was amazing.
Okay.
Sorry, that was a good yeah.
I think the death was pretty brutal. But I think maybe you could have felt that way because I feel the death didn't get the screen time it deserved.
Possibly, right. Yeah.
Because you just see Sansa turning and walking and there's a slight smile and you cut it. And in the next episode, they didn't talk about it at all. So while she wins the war against him, like the war is won, but you want that personal vendetta to reach its high point, right?
Because I mean, this is a house that fucking skins and flays people. That's what they banners.
Yeah, so and, this is what I felt like. But, kutto ko dikha dena, wo noch ke kha rahe wahan par. Thoda time spend karte to zyada satisfying hota.
But even he takes his time breaking a person down emotionally, physically. Like
that's also true.
Sansa and then Theon, like each of them would like they would urinate when he walks into a room and cut his dick off and all that shit happened. Like, so then this was
so just physical torture doesn't seem like
just to see him break down like and then like beg for his own life
and your Jon Snow just like fucking pulps his face like smashes it but you know what I think at the end of the day they're Starks right like they're good people I mean just for them to do all this is like still
I mean but Sansa Stark hai lekin usne diya kutto ko khilaya usne so that's not but bilkul screen time
why do you guys love Game of Thrones
I just think it's the best show that I've ever watched, to be honest. I think I have immersed myself in this universe like no other. I have done Wikipedia scrolls. I have read companion novels. Yeah. I've read the main novels. It's just such a fleshed out story. And I think it speaks to our inner demons so well. And just to understand the extent of where humans can really think and imagine. And the pits to which you can fall. It really does that
dragon pit.
I think it was a very well laid out narrative. Like I invested myself in all of the characters. I mean, each person was given enough time to develop. Like, and you were on this journey with them when they die, and then new character, and then that sort of build up. And for me, as a storyteller, like visually also, they've managed to keep us like arrested like this for over eight years.
9 years.
So that in itself is a testament to why everyone's so hooked onto the show.
I think first off, I think there was never a show really before this that sort of treated fantasy fiction as such a long format story, you know? Mm. Like, iske pehle hamare paas sirf LOTR tha jo popularly known, right? Correct. I mean, I'm keeping the books aside, right?
I know.
But in terms of visual entertainment, like you only had LOTR, which was like 3 movies. Before that, Dungeons and Dragons or something like that, like, you know,
that was like,
you know, you never had something of this elaborate storytelling, you know, on this scale on TV, where they spend so much time on each character, right? And then to sort of first attempt to do that, and then nailing every aspect of it, like you're nailing the characters, you're nailing the story, you're nailing the plot, and the source material obviously was great. Right, so there were so many things that worked so well.
Oh, I like it because it's like Harry Potter with sex and violence.
That's also true.
It's like magic and dragons. Yeah. And people killing. It's like if Gryffindor, Hufflepuff, Slytherin, and Ravenclaw were allowed to attack each other, then what would happen in this game? So I love
Harry Potter.
After Harry Potter, we all needed another universe to obsess over, and I feel like Game of Thrones filled that gap perfectly.
What a great decade.
What will we do after it ends? Okay, we're going to play Fuck, Marry, Kill. Okay, friends. Okay, first for you.
Okay.
Okay. The Mountain, the Hound, the Night King.
Interesting. Fuck the Night King.
You want to fuck him?
Yes. Then...
Different sensation you'll experience.
Totally.
It's all right.
Then the marry the Hound and kill the Mountain.
Yeah, good answer.
Very ambitious.
Yes.
You can kill the Mountain.
Mountain ko marega tu.
Mountain ko
marega. Oberyn nahi
mar saka.
Mere paas Night King hai na. That's why I'm fucking the Night King. He'll help me. Yeah, Hound. I'm marrying the Hound. They both will help me. No?
Correct, correct.
Yeah.
It's true.
Yeah.
Bhai, vav.
Hey, okay, Sharin.
Sudeep.
Sudeep. Brienne, Melisandre and Sir Davos.
Fuck Melisandre.
Obviously.
And get some like power from her.
Correct. One baby will come out of your womb.
Marry and who? Who are the other two?
Brienne and Davos.
Onion Knight.
Of course, marry Brienne. Like she'll, like yeah. she's like personal bodyguard running around
Correct,
with you.
Correct, it's true.
Yes.
And kill apna last guy.
Are you Onion Knight? Why are you killing
him? Why
are
you
nice
killing
guy?
Him? Poor guy, bichara.
I mean, because he could have stopped that.
The game is called Fuck, Marry,
Kill.
And Kill, not Let It Go.
Yeah. Ah, okay, fine.
Huh? Because?
Because he could have saved that kid, but he was like...
Oh, yeah, that's yeah. a good point. Yeah.
He didn't yes. wasn't paying attention.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah. Okay, Sharin.
Huh?
Tyrion,
Ooh.
Tywin, and Olenna.
Obviously, you will marry Tyrion.
Okay.
You will...
You will, nee, you will, like...
I will marry Tyrion because... Fuck, between Olenna and Tywin. I'm not into necrophilia, so I'll obviously kill Tywin. Maybe I'll fuck
And then
Olenna.
Fuck him. Then you'll be into... Okay.
Fuck Olenna.
She'll be like cheating.
But she's dead.
Oh, she's also dead.
Yeah, remember? Tell Cersei I did it.
So I'll oh, call yeah. the Lord of the Light to come and bring her back to life so I can fuck her. Because
okay.
I've thought about it. Huh? So
okay.
then I will marry...
She's called Tyrion. Queen of Thorns. Oh, cool, no problem.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah, you'll work
and
with
then, it. Yeah, Tywin obviously has to be killed, man.
Cool, thanks, sure. friends. Thanks.
Okay.
Thanks, friends, for
thanks
this very educational game of fuck, marry, kill.
Bless, thanks.
Did yeah. you finish yours?
Oh, I don't have mine. You will have to make one up. Make one up for
okay.
me.
Okay. I'll,
okay.
You name one character, you name one character.
Okay, cool.
Rob Stark.
Varys, Rob Stark, and Jon Snow.
अरे ये तो बहुत आसान है. I'll marry Jon Snow, then I get to also sit on the Iron Throne. Then I will fuck Rob Stark because of. Is that even a question? And I'll kill Varys.
Why are you killing Varys?
I don't know. He's taklu.
Oh. Okay.
I like hair.
Bald people should die.
First. All bald men die. Must die.
So. Advisory. Statutory.
Okay, thank you, friends.
Okay, thank you
so
much.
For this episode.
Yes, thank you, Giri. Thank you, Sudeep, for joining us and gracing our sets. Yes, thank you.
Thank you. We could have just done this in our homes over
and over. Yeah. But it's fun. It's a couple thing to do, so.
Correct. And I mean, they don't read. So, I mean, Giri reads. He reads.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Audiobooks.
Audiobooks.
Sometimes.
Audiobooks.
This
is the future, children. Like, please listen. Don't read.
Chale, hut.
Storytell.
Oh, storytell.
Of course, this is not
a Okay, thank you guys for watching.
Okay.
Season premiere, April 14th. Yay!
Yes, we're very excited. And we will be clued in. And please do comment and leave comments.
After you comment, please remember to.
Yes.
Leave another.
Yeah. Is Don't at us. Write to us and tell us about what are the things that you love about the show.
What
do you like
about to
in the season finale?
Yeah,
and